Welcome to the Journey Home. My name is Catherine and I live in Nova Scotia, Canada. The following is an oracle reading of cards that I have chosen for you that I will read fully from and without advertisement. So please subscribe, hit that like, and share. Enjoy your reading. This card chosen for you is from the Fairies Oracle by Brian Froud. Card number 23, the Green Woman. Wildness, natural magic, expectant gratitude, untrammeled creativity. The Green Woman dances naked in the moonlight and in the sunlight and the shadows as well. She doesn't care what you think of her. She knows her own worth from her experience of life. She is the feminine, vital, vegetative force that enables a root to crack stone, the reed to bend in the wind, and the oak to stand against the storm. The graceful, slow-motion dance of the Green Woman shows us how to release the constraints of artificial rules and limitations and find our true pattern of growth. Each of us, rooted or not, has an inborn pattern of perfection to guide our growth. Earth Mother nurtures us, Sun Father energizes us, storms batter us, and sometimes we must bend before them. Other life preys upon us on the hand and nourishes and supports us on the other. Within the framework of the real world, we seek our path to realizing our own potential and finding our own fulfillment. The Green Woman reminds us that where the ground is fertile, something will grow. It may be nettles or thistles, or roses or carrots or sand burrs or peaches, but it will be something because fertile earth never remains empty. She tells us to stay earthed, to attend to our own growing ground, keeping it fertile, aerated, and well watered, and to pay attention to what grows there. It is up to us to root out what we don't want within ourselves and to nurture what we do. She also reminds us to count our blessings and deal with our difficulties. A tree grows where the seed falls, as do all of our rooted brothers and sisters. They teach us of the importance of making the best of what comes to us, showing patience and perseverance in adversity. When a plant is thirsty, it can only do limited things to assuage its thirst, like slowly driving its roots deeper in search of water. But mostly it must wait for water to come to it. Although we have legs and can often take action to get what we want, or at least try to, there are some things beyond our reach. These are the things we can learn from the Green Woman's example, waiting patiently and with gratitude, expectant gratitude. Yet at the same time, she counsels us to take risks, to let new and unfamiliar wild seeds grow and see what they may become. Watch them closely. Some of them may be miracles waiting to happen in our lives. As we develop our own free and untrammeled creativity, the Green Woman grows with us. The message for you here is that the Green Woman speaks to us of caring for our growing ground and of the physical satisfaction of being our natural selves and practicing our own innate magic. This is a time for enhancing the growth of our talents and abilities, a time of blossoming that will bear fruit. It may also be a time of growing maturity and self-confidence. Experience trusting yourself and trusting the process of growth. She also reminds us of material reward ahead, the harvest of the seeds we have planted and nurtured. She counsels boldness and perseverance in the face of adversity, yet she also reminds us that sometimes the only action we can take is to wait patiently and keep growing. When her energy is blocked, growth is stunted. Twisted, the energy of growth goes awry, and we move in directions that are either dead ends or simply inappropriate for us. Or perhaps we try to shift from one extreme to another, between growth and stasis, which only yields twisted, stunted, and warped results. In its destructive mode, the energy of growth grows wild. Cancers, both physical and emotional, may result. Alternatively, there may be no growth at all, but in fairy and this world both, we must either grow or die. We cannot simply hold still. Before I read the second card for you, just a reminder to please hit the like and help me beat those algorithms. For every like that you give me is potentially 1,000 suggestions and recommendations on YouTube. Thank you and God bless. Enjoy the rest of the reading. This card chosen for you is from the Fairy Forest, an oracle of the wild green world by Lucy Cavendish. Card number 41. Awen. Gift, divine inspiration, awakening. Awen translates to divine inspiration or flowing breath. It is a mystical force that offers us a moment where there is a sudden surge in newfound knowledge, inspired thought, the ability to awaken our dormant talents, and a sense that before we were given the gift of Awen, we were like sleepwalkers. Awen is a moment where life is forever changed. And once we drink of Awen, or feel it as a beam of divine light entering us and changing us, we can never return to who we were, and the world is never the same again. So when the card comes to you, you must know now that having experienced what has taken place, you cannot pretend life can ever be the same. You have lifted the veil, and you have seen the face of the divine. You have drunk the elixir of the gods, and the fairies have offered you their greatest gift. Awen does not stay, but the knowledge of what we have experienced in that moment changes us forever. So now that you have had this life-changing experience and been given this incredible moment of inspiration, you can either pretend to yourself that life is without magic, or you can continue to embrace the magic and the enchantment of every moment. Now, if you choose, you can become more fully alive. And while this is not no easy path, it is one that is full of deep, joyful moments, true connections, and poetic, blindingly beautiful experiences. Awen will come from time to time, and you are so blessed for having had this most sublime and life-changing of all mystical experiences. Artwork, Snow White. If you're still here, thanks for listening to this oracle reading. And please join us Wednesdays and Sunday nights live. If you would like some free cards pulled for you, I would love to pull them for you. Check the website out too. There are all kinds of perks for members over there. God bless and talk to you again soon. Bye-bye for now.